Drivers, start your engines!
What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the Bora FedEx Amateur Series Season 5, race number 3 from Nashville. Now, starting on the front row, you have a Brad Keselowski Racing lockout. You have Tammy Dirk and Gary Alsup. Row 2, you have Danny Coffey, your points leader, and Nick Flood, your all-time wins leader in the Premier Series and the RCR All-Star Ride. Then you have Ryan Spengler and Seth Ismail, David Cervantes and Steve Love, Joe Jefferson and Daniel Colt, Cynthia Bright and Paul Wright, Steve Larker and Dylan Abrahamian, Daniel Guitereau and Drew Glass. So we have 38 laps from Nashville. The LCQ actually had quite a bit of passing, which is really, really new for Nashville. So hopefully this race will be as interesting as that one was. Green flag is out, 38 laps. Will everyone make it to the green? They will. Danny Coffey won last week at Phoenix. He's going to try going back-to-back. He's already your points leader. Second in points, Damian Malorn qualified all the way back in 32nd. So hopefully after his pit stops, he can rebound. But until then, man, Danny Coffey, it's his championship to lose already. Tammy Dirk is gone. He's checked out. Seth Ismail trying to get past his teammate for second. Oh, Ryan Spengler and Nick Flood make contact. Now they're three wide. David Cervantes in the middle. Daniel Colt making a bold move. Oh, Gary Alsup. The pack's crazy, man. They're crazy. The 43 of Steve Larker had a really fast car in the LCQ. He's broke into the top 10 here. Right now there's a half second between first and second, so we're going to show the battles throughout the pack. It's so early on. Steve Larker is flying. Nick Flood all over the back bumper of the 43, almost a brake check. Oh, and Nick's gonna almost turn him around. Oh my goodness. Gary also is gonna take advantage. Ooh, it looks like Nicholas Cook almost getting turned by Dade Honeywell. All the way back, just outside the top 10. Ooh, and caution is out. We'll be right back, see what just happened. Joseph Gibson, man, in the 79 for Everham. Oh. Luke Eberline. Ooh, the 83. Barely getting me. Or barely missing that. The other three of Keegan Alsup Jr. and Nick Alsup. Man, everyone. All the Alsups getting involved. Ellis Garrett, man. Imagine running in last and still almost getting caught up in someone else's crash. Not a big crash, though, by any means. None of them are going to DNF off this. So we're back to restart. And the pace car is off. Steve Larker is your leader. I'm going to be honest. I don't really know what happened on pit road. The whole lineup is different now, though. Steve Larker is your leader. Then you have Daniel Colt, Gary Alsup, Eric Draven, and Paul Wright rounding out your top five. Lap 9 of 38. A lot of racing to go. Tammy Dirk definitely did pit, though. She pit from the lead. Coming out into 8th. She had a really big lead as well. Let's see if she has a good car in the pack as she does in clean air. Oh, and Brayson Mitchell for Nick Ventura Racing has a problem. Wonder if it's a camshaft. Actually, it's Champion Motorsports prepared by Nick Ventura Racing. Ooh, what is happening with the 40 and the 9? Steve Larker with a pretty good sized lead. Over Gary also. If he had a really good car in the LCQ, man, we said if he gets the lead, he's going to be dangerous for the pick. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh. Everyone is driving so aggressively, man. Tammy Dirk, she knows she's got a fast car. Does she have the patience to get up there? Gary also slowly reeling in Steve Larker. Talks to the caution lights on. It's basically no. Eric Draven looking to go to the inside of Gary also. Maybe not. Wasn't quite close enough to make the move. And now the cautions. I thought I saw the caution lights on, man. Alright, we'll be right back to see what just happened. And this wreck started up really far towards the front, man. Paul Wright inside the top 10 in the one car. It looks like David Cervantes and his teammate Daniel Cole are going to get into it and just hook in the one. Ooh, Cynthia Bright's going to get it. Nick Flood almost did. Kyle the Stinger Kesey's going to get a piece of it. Oh my god, the 8's going to go upside down. James Stabilito's in it. I saw the 88 get a little airborne. And then Ryan Madden just going to yeet his way into that. The 8 of Dylan Everhimian, man. A wild ride for that DEI number 8. Aw, James Stabilito got Arca braked, and that's what flipped the 8. Alright, we'll be back for the restart. Coming to the green on lap 16 of 38, Tammy Dirk is back in lead as everyone else did pit. They've cycled back around. The 52 is back out there. A couple laps down, though. 3 laps down. So Tammy Dirk's in your lead. Then you have Alex Joaquin, Nick Flood, Dade Honeywell, and then Joseph Gibson in 5th. Alright. Your victim from the first crash. Brayson's going to try desperately getting one of his laps back here. That's going to help Nick Flood. That's going to hurt Tammy Dirk. Now that 52 wants a caution right now. Oh, and Nick has no patience for the 52's nonsense. He's going to just fly to the inside, nearly making contact. Oh, but they ain't giving up. Tammy Dirk's going to fight back on the outside. Oh, the 52 almost making contact with the 31. That's going to be all she wrote. Nick's going to get a huge run through turns 1 and 2. Tammy Dirk's going to be the victim of this. How about the 83 of the BK Racing Toyota of Ellis Garrett, man. He was in last place when he got caught up in that wreck, and now he's inside the top 10. Pit strategy at its finest. That's awesome. Nick Flood won the LCQ, trying to be the second driver in Bora history to win the LCQ and win the race. Ooh, Eric Draven giving the 83 a bump and run. Joe Jefferson, Tammy Dirk, there they go. Ah, Tammy had one of the fastest cars. Oh my god, what a hit. Oh no. Oh, Luke Ryan. Oh, Danny Coffey, your points leader. Oh, that's a scary hit. That was a really hard hit for Tammy Dirk in the number 12. Hopefully she is all right. We'll be right back to see what just happened. Here we are watching Tammy Dirk, man. One of the hardest hits I've seen definitely all season. God, that's a hard hit. Right into the driver's side. Shit, so hard it damaged her roof. And Luke Ryan, man. Man, don't even know what hit him. He doesn't even, like, 0 to 100 real quick. Danny Coffey, let's see what happened to him. All the way back in 24th. Not a great day for the points leader. He's just minding his own business. And he almost had it cleared, but the KBM number 4 just kind of clipped him. We're going to go on board number 12 of Tammy Dirk for this one. Oh my god, what a hit. Oh. See how fast was she going when she hit that wall? Miles per hour. Right to the driver's side. And then where is he? I'm going the wrong way for one. And Luke Ryan. miles per hour head on. Tammy was almost at a complete stop. That's ridiculous. We're back for the restart. Coming to lap 23 of 38, Eric Draven is now your leader. Tammy Dirk, who's had one of the best cars all day, she is out of this race. You can see DNF. Danny Coffey, 31st. Tammy Dirk, 33rd. Brayson Mitchell up to 32nd, though. He's not giving up in that 52. Eric Draven gonna fly by him though. Nicholas Cook and teammate Daniel Cole battling it out for second. Ryan Spangler fourth. Kyle the Stinger Kesey inside the top five for Kesey Motorsports. That was short-lived though. Daniel Guidereau gonna blow by him. Oh my god! Dade Honeywell upside down off turn number four, barrel rolling down the front stretch. Clipped by Joe Jefferson. That's a big, big crash. Someone else is... Oh no. Joseph Gibson upside down. Okay. Whatever actually just happened. Dade Honeywell and Carter Friesen having a really scary crash here off turn number four. Joe Jefferson's just going to clip him. I want to go on board. Or not even on board, just get a better view. Joseph Gibson is the reason Dade Honeywell just flipped. And then he flipped on his own afterwards. He kind of just like drove underneath the 51. Oh my gosh, what hit. Keegan Allsup Jr. going to send him pack in. Paul Wright's in it. Cynthia Bright a little bit as well. Wow, we're back for the restart. Pace car is off, coming to lap 28 of 38, 11 to go. Steve Larker is still your leader. We see DNF'd off that one. Joe Jefferson lost an ignition. Paul Wright lost a piston. You have Dade Honeywell. All the way down to Carter Friesen of DNF. Race match up to 27th. Still trying to get those laps back as Steve Larker is still your leader. Then you have Alex Joaquin, Nick Flood, Jack Marks, who is third in points coming in. He's had a really quiet day. And then Gary Allsup running out your top five. Oh, Gary Allsup all over Nick Flood. Ten laps to go here in the FedEx Amateur Series Season 5, race number 3 from Nashville. Oh, Nick Flood almost going to run through Brace Mitchell. He's going to... Oh, Nick Flood turned by Jack Marks. Oh, man, he had a lift for the lap car of Mitchell, and it's going to end up costing him. Is that, I don't think that's going to be... Oh, that is a caution. Interesting. They're racing back yet again. For 9 to go, we'll be right back to see what just happened. Jack Marks out here looking out for the little guy. There's Nick Flood all over the 52. Not on his watch. That's basically... Hey, man, nothing else happened. We're back to 3 start. The pace car pulls off on lap 34 of 38. 5 laps to go here in Nashville. Steve Larker is your leader. Then you have Alex Joaquin, Gary Allsup, Xavier Rain, and Laura Delano. 52 is laps down, obviously. Gary Allsup will try making quick work of Alex Joaquin. He will be successful. Oh, man, the 52 is a huge run. Pretty shot in the inside of Laura Delano. A couple females going at it. Steve Love in the 11. Eric Draven with a huge run in the number 40. Jack Marks all over the 11. Oh, man. 4 laps to go for Steve Larker. He is over half a second lead. Oh, Brayson Mitchell trying to help out Steve Larker as best he can as he gets to the inside of Gary Allsup. Ooh, people are pitting. Is this a fuel mileage race, I wonder? I don't know what's going on. Is anyone else going to pit? I wonder if that was just a bad strategy call. I don't know. Steve Larker is a lapped car between him and second. It's almost a full second here, 3 laps to go. Does Steve Larker have enough fuel to make it is the question. A couple Chevys on pit road. An RCR and a Kevin Harvick Incorporated car. Alex Joaquin's fallen back since the restart. Here he started second. Here he is losing. Oh, people are pitting. Interesting. Eric Draven nearly dumping his teammate. There's no caution. White flag is... Or 2 laps ago. Never mind. This is really interesting. Steve Larker still leading. Now you have Steve Love and then Gary Allsup. Eric Draven, Jack Marks. And Oxford King running out your top 5. I don't even know what's going on right now. So I guess this is technically a fuel mileage race, but only for some of them. Strategy calls that did not work out. Interesting. It's all Steve Larker up front, the white flag in the air here in Nashville. Richard Petty Motorsports continuing their dominant season. Not even continuing, I guess. But continuing their success from last year. Steve Harker can be yet another rookie at Richard Petty Motorsports to find victory lane. Nearly running over the 8. Oh my god. Steve Love might lose a second because of his teammate. Gary Alsup, is he going to get held up? Oh my goodness. David Cervantes picking up a ton of spots at the end. Whew. He owes Dylan Erbahemian a thank you letter. We'll be back to look at your official results. Steve Larker, your winning photos up on the top right now. Your official top 10. Go Steve Larker with the win. Then you have Steve Love in second, Eric Draven third, Gary Alsup fourth, and David Cervantes coming out of nowhere to steal that fifth place finish. Then you have Alex Joaquin, Jack Marks, Daniel Colt, Nicholas Cook, and Ryan Spengler running out your top 10. Notables outside the top 10. How about Elias Garrett right at the end? Not even at the end, but that BK Racing car getting 12th. Kyle the Stinger Kesey in 14th, man. That's cool. I love seeing these underfunded guys get a really good finish. Nick Flood, man. He was going for that win. Trying to get his first ever amateur series win. He's going to get 21st after pitting at the end and having that incident with Jack Marks and Brayson Mitchell. You can see everyone else finish, though. There's like 25th through 42nd or whatever. 24 cars finished the race, 16 in lead lap. That was probably one of the more entertaining national races we've had. I don't know if it'll return to the schedule next season, though. But congratulations to Steve Larker. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. Tomorrow will be the Premier Series race from Las Vegas. That should be a really good one. So hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, see you guys next time. Good. Boy, can you make fans stand and scream your name? Have you hit them in the ass? Never let off the gas till you rode into victory lane. He said, boy, do you know how it feels when you're running 3 wide? Cause if you're Daytona bound, let me wonder you're in for a ride.